So we're still after the center of a group. We've looked at the dihedral group, so I just want to show you the dihedral group in six elements, as we promised, because we're going to find the center of this massive group. So if I stand aside, there you can see my six-sided polygon, and I've named it 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. The six points here on the side, the corners. And let's do a bit of swapping this around so that when I do something to it and you look away and you look back, apart from these numbers, when these numbers gone, this figure stays exactly like it is now. So number one is very simply, we do nothing. One stays at one, two, two, and two, three stays in three, no problem there. Let's rotate it by 60 degrees. If I rotate it by 60 degrees, you're not going to know the difference if these are not there. But one is going to go to two, two is going to go to three, three to four, four to five, five to six, six to one. So that is going to be that permutation. And one goes to two, two goes to three, three goes to four, four goes to five, five goes to six, six goes back to one. So that's one rotation through 60 degrees. But let's rotate it twice, and we'll call that sigma squared. So one is going to go to three, two is going to go to four, three is going to go to five, four is going to go to six, and six is going to go to two. So let's see what that happens there. One goes to three, one goes to three, so one goes to one, two, three goes to one, two, three goes to five, and five goes back to one, so we have to close that, and then two, two is going to go to four, which is going to go to six, which is going to go back to two. So we see that cycle. Now we can do it three times, so that's 180 degrees pi radians that we're going to go. One goes to one, two, three, one goes to four, two goes to five, three goes to six, and we rotate it through 180 degrees, and we see there. Now we can rotate one all the way to five, and we can rotate one all the way to six, and we see it there. And if we do all the way to six, one goes to six, six to five, five to four, four to three, three to two, two back to one. So that's one thing that we can do. But what about just flipping these? So let's flip them. Let's flip it along this axis here. So one is going to stay with one. One is going to stay with one, and four is going to go to four. But two and six will swap, and three and five will swap. So we get 2 and 6 will swap, and 3 and 5 will swap. So that's along this axis. If we fix these two points and flip it along this, 2 and 5 are going to stay. 2 and 5 are going to stay, but you can see what's going to happen to 3 and 6 and 1 and 4. And then finally, we can do along this axis, and 2 is going to go to 4, and 1 is going to go to 5, 5 goes to 1, and 4 goes to 2. But there are three more lines that we can draw through this, and we can rotate. If we take this axis here and we go 90 degrees up against it right there, if we flip that, we see 1 and 2, 3 and 6 and 4 and 5 are going to go 90 degrees along this one, which means here, I flip it here, 1 and 4, 2 and 3 and 5 and 6 are going to go, and 90 degrees along this one, in other words down there, we get 3 and 4, 2 and 5 and 1 and 6 that are going to go. So we see, as we expected, we see these 12 elements that we can make up, 2 n, n being 6. We see these 12 specific permutations that we can do in this dihedral group. And this is a dihedral group with an even number of elements in the set. Even number of elements in the set. And when we have a dihedral group with even numbers, the following is going to happen. We're going to see the center, just remember this for now because we haven't discussed what a center is. The center is going to be, in the center, we're going to have the trivial rotation there, nothing happens, and the 180 degree or pi radians rotations. So the one where one goes to four and four goes to one, one goes to four, four goes to one, two goes to five, and 5 goes to 2, 3 goes to 6, and 6 goes to 3. That's going to be, these two are going to be very special. So if we have a dihedral group in even elements, the identity element and the 180 degree rotations are going to form what we call the center of a group. And I'm going to go quickly to Mathematica, and I'm just going to show you a screenshot of that So we can have a look at these two very specific, what happens to these two very specific if we look at the group, so that is the dihedral group in six elements, that is this dihedral group in six elements, it's set in this binary operation of just combining any two of these, that with a binary operation there. And we're going to see something very special. Of course, that one, it's the trivial one, there's always something special about it, but there's something very special about this 180 degree rotation as well. Let's go have a look. So there we go, we see Cayley's table as we did before for the six elements, the dihedral group in six elements, which gives us these 12 permutations, and Mathematica here has just numbered them 1 to 12, but 1 would be the identity element, and I want you to have a look at element number 8 here, which is actually the rotation through pi radians. So 1 goes to 4 and 4 goes to 1, 2 goes to 5 and 5 goes to 2, and 3 goes to 6 and 6 goes to 3. Have a look at this. The identity element will always commute, because composing with anything or anything with it in the set, that is always going to commute. But have a look at this rotation here, which Mathematica has called 8 here. Just take my word for it, that this is the rotation through 180 degrees. If I compose 8 with 1, I get 8. And if I compose 1 with 8, I get 8, obviously. But have a look at this. If I compose 8 then with the next element, which is 2 here, I get 7. And if I take 2 composed with 8, I get 7 as well. And 8 with 3 is 9, and 3 with 8 is also 9. 10, 10, 12, 12, 11, 11, 2, 2, 1, 1, 3, 3, 4, 4, 6, 6, 5, 5. There's commutivity here. There's something very special about this element, the identity element, and the rotation through 180 degrees. That element, that permutation, they commute with all others. And these two elements, they form a subgroup. We're going to show that, prove that that is a subgroup of G, and that is actually then those two elements is what is called the center of G.